tips and tricks on how to fish flipping jigs and various types of. Thing you want to do is pick the right jig for what you're doing. I like a 3/8 ounce gunmetal head, a bluegill jig. We'll fanned out weed guard here, and a sharpened Gamagatsu hook with a nice sweet beaver trailer. Now what you're doing, what I'm flipping here is some lilies and a little bit of buckbrush. What I like to do on the lilies is just send it as far back as you can back there in the lilies. Let it sink down. Fishing with 15-pound fluorocarbon, 7.31 Daiwa Tattoo reel, and a 7'2" skeet reese rod, medium heavy. What I'm doing is let it sit down there, wait for it to go slack, pop it with the butt of my rod. These skirts do is they flare out when they hit the bottom, flare out. Now I have to get bait fish. So what you do, send it back there, see as it skips, as you send it back there without even trying, when you're flipping it without even trying. Let it sit there, pop a couple times, get no bites. When you get weeds on it, reel in, send it another one. One, we're fishing probably the inside edge, sometimes the outside, stuff that sticks out, 20 kilo lilies, stuff like that. Sometimes, most of the time, it's sunny, like today, but they're going to be way back up in there, looking for the fish will be looking for shade, especially on hot days, water temperature's hot, everything else. But trees like this that stick out in the channel are what's going to give you fish. There's a lot of times there's going to be fish out here, under this bush, pretty much sticking out of the buckbrush. It's going to have a lot of fish. Don't be afraid to stick it way back in there. If you hook into one, fly a fish with 15-pound fluoro that can pull through there, or a lot of braid. Big, strong braid, 30, 40, 50-pound braid will get the job done easily. And a lot of times, you might flip to the right side of the bush. Bush, not get a bite. With dip on it, not get a bite. You gotta cover all the sides. It's hot, it's sunny, and it gets hot, these fish don't move very much. And a lot of flips is key, because these fish aren't gonna chase down bait very easily. You gotta put it in their base. Those are many of the keys to fishing buckbrush and lilies. A lot of times when you come up to a patch of the moon like this, they're going to be in and out, and these little, what I would call them, little coves and these lilies, a lot of times is places where you're going to get a lot of your fish off the points of them, right there, or way back into them from the other point also. And a lot of times there's these little inlets that are coming up to over here. It goes in and it opens up. Well, a lot of times there could be fish back there, and there's also, like in this instance, there's a lot of floating lily reeds, pulled lilies down and play together. And there, a lot of times there'll be fish laying up near these. The whole learning how to fish all this is key. Lots of practice. Knowing what you're doing is the thing. What you're bait is doing down there. That's why I buy these 9/11 jigs. They go down there, they sit, and the head sticks up a little bit. The head's in the fore, so it sits like this. And that hook is just ready to get set. But weed guards are perfect. Not too strong where you're gonna miss a hook set. Not too soft where you're gonna get hung up on. And these skirts will flare out. A lot of times that's why I'm fishing a bluegill. These bass are taking bluegill around there and bluegill is falling. I'm fishing docks. You know, just that little hop with the flare. A lot of times it's going to get those fish to go. They're gonna see that flare. They're going to come and hit it. Sometimes you're going to be fishing with lilies. And you're going to be going down. You're all starting to come up on a patch. It goes flat to graze lilies. A lot of times, big keys for big fish. Now in the springtime, the fish are way back, they're spawning. I go park the boat back there, and all I do is flip up and down the patch of lilies where it goes from flat to up. And most of the time, it produces a lot of big fish. Big fish like to lay up in the strong lilies, but bait fish and everything else like to lay in there, so it's a good ambush point for the bass. You're fishing the raised lilies or flat lilies, you call it really almost like a penny grass. Not really lilies, but not really like reeds or anything, but they're just small. That, a lot of times, flipping that will give you a lot of good fish. And then, a lot of times you come up, you're fishing all that's left is these little lilies. Not big flat ones, but small flat ones. A lot of times that will produce fish for the field. It all just depends on what the fish are keying into that day. If they like the flat lilies, go find a big type of flat lilies. If you're fishing, and you see they're sitting on the edges, throw a frog on the edges, you can get any bite. But a lot of times, going to be the key to your success. A lot of times you'll come down a line of lilies and it's going to switch to a patch of reeds. Reeds are very hard to flip sometimes because you can't send it way back in there. The best thing you can do is sometimes send it way up into the bush and pull it out of the bush and land it right on the edge the more it goes from the lilies to the water. It's going to that way, because most of the time these fish are going to be 6 to 8 inches off that reed wall, which is what we have here, the big wall, lots of floating milfoil around it. So what you want to do is just set it way back in there with 15 pound fluoro coming in there. I can't stress you enough, best line. Fishing P-line fluorocarbon, fluoroqueer, which is a copolymer, it's like fluorocarbon. Get a little bit of stretch of the mono. Helps you fight the fish a lot better. If you get stuck a lot like I am right now, you got this stretch, you don't break your rod. But your jig will also come out like that. And a lot of these times, the fish are going to be laying up there 6 to 8 inches off that wall. Because when those reeds start, there's a wall where the reeds are, so they're going to be laying off that wall, and a lot of times you'll see these flat lilies here also along with them. Once again, it's all about where the fish are going to be. If you find reeds, if you find that they're biting on reeds, go find a patch of reeds. A lot of times when you're fishing around docks, people are going to have their boats full. Best thing to do, they're going to have their lips open. Once again, the corners are what's going to give you the fish. A lot of people got floats, people that swim on, stuff like that. You want to do? Best thing to do, flip the corner. The corners are what's going to give you your bites. Once again, if you're pulling out, knock it a little bit, and a lot of times, it only takes one or two.